Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And we did a live stream recently. Of course, we do one almost every Saturday of the year. But Robert Barbeau attended the live stream. He asked this question. He was like, hey, Adam, Patrick, is there any good way to convert a filtered visual into a measure? It's like, whew, yeah, of course you can. And he's like, well, can you show me? Of course I can. So instead of all this talking, you know what I would like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say you start with a report, I have a data model here, and I'm gonna create a card. So I add total sales amount, and there's my card with a value, and then I'm gonna add a filter to this visual. I'm gonna drag state of province over here to the filters on visual section, and let's just choose Alabama. So $71.57. And so let's turn on performance analyzer. This is where I would start to get the DAX, so that I can convert that into a measure. So what I would do is turn on performance analyzer, click the plus sign, turn on performance analyzer, go to the performance analyzer pane, start recording, and refresh this visual. Before all you DAX experts out there go, Patrick, this is a really simple DAX measure to write. It absolutely is, but that's not what Robert asked. He said, hey, can you convert this filtered visual into a measure? And I'm like, yeah, so that's why I'm doing this. So calm down, you DAX experts. I'm gonna go ahead and expand this. And if you turn on the preview feature for DAX Query View, you can choose run in DAX Query View. So I'm gonna go ahead and click this. It runs this. So here's the DAX that it needs to create the measure. And so what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna create a new line, and I'm gonna say measure equals internet sales, and we're gonna give this our own name, right? Total sales for Alabama. Then I'm gonna get rid of this equal sign right here because that's not the correct syntax. And then I'll put equal right there. So now I have this variable. It's actually filtering this measure, okay? That's the measure I'm using in the visual. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy this. And I'm gonna create one, another one. Result equals calculate, paste this here. And then what I'm gonna do is use this right here as my filter, okay? Because I wanna filter this measure by that value. And then what I'm gonna do is copy this, go down here, I'm gonna comment this part out, okay? It's a lot of steps, and I'm gonna show you how you can do this a little simpler towards the end, but you asked how we can convert it. And so what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use my table constructor, and then I have one little last thing to do here, return my result. So now if I run this, see it's 71.57, if I run this, I get the exact same thing. Everybody's watching going, oh God, why didn't you just write the calculate statement? Why didn't you make that the result of the measure? You're absolutely correct. But the question was, can I convert a filtered visual into a measure? So using performance analyzer, using the new DAX query view, I'm able to do this directly in the desktop. Now let me wrap this up and show you how you would even further simplify this. So we're gonna define this measure, and we're gonna take this piece right here, and we don't need any of this geography, state, province, equals Alabama. And then if I get rid of all of this stuff, you don't need that. And if I run this, it's 71.57. And now what I can do is uncomment this and take this. This is my measure right here. I'm gonna cut that, get that on my clipboard. And then right here, I'm gonna paste my measure name, and I'm gonna change this total sales amount, Alabama. And I don't need that filter or this parentheses. A lot, it's a lot, I know. But now in the query view, I can execute my new measure, see there's a value. And then if I want to, because I'm using summarized columns, I can do this calendar year, and I'm gonna run this. And now you can see it breaks it down by calendar year. So what I'm gonna do to wrap this up, I'm gonna go ahead and add this. I'm gonna update my model. Yes, add this to my model. There it goes, right? Total sales for Alabama. If I jump back over to my report view and I delete this, and then I make a little table so you can see if you compare the results of my DAX query, let's stop this. So we're gonna add this, and then we're gonna go find calendar year. There we go, calendar year. And now if you look at the results, you can see it's 71.57, and then for 2012, $7.43 for 2014. If I go to my DAX query, I see the exact same thing. Not trivial. You definitely can get an indication of how you want to define that measure using Power BI, Performance Analyzer, and the DAX Query View. And you can start tinkering. You can actually learn how to write DAX queries in Power BI Desktop. And maybe I'll come and do a video like getting started writing DAX queries. All right, what do you think? Questions, comments? Robert, I hope this answered your question. If you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about DAX and writing DAX, I'm sure there's a video probably flying over my head right now. And as always, from Adam myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.